Hey guys, welcome to Surf and Show. I'm Noel Salas, and today's surf tip is how to custom order your small wave high performance board. Now I want to identify the category. Some board builders call it step downs, daily drivers, but it's really these boards that have that high performance shortboard outline, but they have less rocker, the nose and tail are a little bit wider, and they're really designed for that 1 to 6 foot surf. Now you guys ask me all the time, how long can I stretch it? How wide and how thick before the board starts to lose its performance in the way it was designed? I hooked up with Britt Merrick. We talk about this category. I think you guys are gonna like it. Check it out. All right, Britt, so you helped us out with the Ultra Joe hybrid category, that wider nose. I'm gonna push you to similar questions because I feel like we kind of went up from a stock Ultra Joe Groveler, for me comes in at that 5.3, 5.4, and now we're into like an OG Flyer, Rocket Wide, Neckbeard 2 type board, where it's got a bit less rocker, high performance outline. I call them small wave performance boards. And I feel like these type of boards hit my numbers almost to the T in stock dimensions. So I don't find myself really customizing the Grovelers or even your guys's step downs. So maybe we can talk about that a little bit. I feel like in Southern California and a lot of other places in the world, we're riding, you know, 5 to 6 foot and under waves, where I prefer these type of boards over a high performance shortboard.
Yeah, well, first of all, this is, as you said, this is my favorite category of board, right? This is where I have, I think, the most fun, other than twin fins right now.
Sure.
The step down thruster, right? Or the, if you want to call it the groveler, whatever, small wave performance, I think is perfect. Because guys like us, we're performance board guys, we're thruster guys. But most of the waves we're riding are, as you said, pretty soft. So you step down this, you're just having so much more fun, so much more speed, so much more flow. So I think this is a really important board category. I think a lot of people maybe overlook this. You got to have a step down or two in your quiver. And I find that most of the time I'm surfing one of those. So the way that you dialed that in is I think it wants to live in the space that's an inch or two shorter than your shortboard.
Okay.
Right, is that where you're riding it?
My shortboard's 5'7".
Exactly.
Right.
Right, so you're in that 2 inch shorter range, effectively.
Yep.
If we're talking about the neck beard, you could go a little smaller.
Right.
You know, Dane Reynolds, his shortboard is a 6'0", his neck beard's a 5'9".
Right.
So there's 4 inches shorter. But generally around 2 inches shorter for this board.
Sure.
And then I think you just ride your same width and your same thickness as you would on your shortboard.
Okay.
You can go up a little bit if you want to, you know, keep the leaders. But the idea with these is you just have a more responsive board and you don't need to make up in width and thickness as much because the design of the board has that built in. It's going to have a wider tail, a wider nose, a little straighter outline, and a straighter rocker, and it's generally gonna carry more foam in the foil of the board, right? So you don't have to compensate as much with your width and your thickness. You can just drop a couple inches, stay at the same width and thickness, and be really close.
Right.
Does that make sense?
Agreed, agreed. So I think like on a Neckbeard 2, it's like 18 7/8. Give me a rule of thumb on that stock 5.5. Let's say I wanted to push it up a little bit in width. Maybe just having a little bit more surface area could get me even faster in a mushier wave to maybe like 19, would you say?
Yeah, I think an eighth inch is a good increment. Now, the neck beard, you know, I almost put the neck beard closer to the Ultra Joe, although it's much more performance, but as far as sizing down and sizing up, you know what I mean? Dane, his short boards are 19 and an eighth. His 5.9 neck beards are 19 5/8, right? So it's a half inch. There's that like half inch parameter that we were talking about earlier. So I think we're really talking more Rocket Wide, OG Flyer, this type of board. And I think if you want to go up a little bit, an eighth to a quarter inch is where you want to live on width.
Okay.
And a 16th to an eighth on thickness.
Perfect.
Because again, these are performance boards and really the characteristics that you need for the groveling component, for the small wave component is built into the design.
Right.
You're not having to make it up dimensionally.
Perfect. That helps a ton. I hope it helps our community make some good choices on ordering a custom. Thanks. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed today's surf tip. remember the board category. This is small wave, high performance boards, your daily drivers that sit right underneath your high performance shortboard. And it doesn't really matter who the board builder is. If they offer stock dimensions, we should be able to take the general rule of thumb that Britt helped us with to order this board with confidence. Look, if you like our show, subscribe, ring the bell so you don't miss an episode, and give us a thumbs up if you like our content. Special shout out thanks to Britt Merrick for helping us with this episode. Until next time, we'll see you in the water. Bye-bye.